because he said it was their parents. I said, sure, you can do cremations, we can do one per grave. And holy heck, did that open up a can of worms. They were threatened to sue me because they wanted to be buried there, and why did I let them be buried there? And
that's why I'm surprised you can sell the lot, because they own the property whether they ever use it or not.
Well, here's the thing, is if it's an unclaimed lot, by state law, if nobody is buried in there, and there's no headstone, we can't locate anybody, we have, and we've done everything by the state law, we have the right to resell those lots.
That makes sense.
And that is state law.
Uh-huh.
You can go online and search.
So if a headstone or a bench is there, then it's secured.
Correct. Mm-hmm. On those lots.
Yeah.
If there's lots to the sides, then those could be sold if there's no family to find.
Good to know.
My grandmother,
buy me too.
And
Jeff
and I.
For the
first time, a couple months ago.
Want to be buried in deep care?
And they were able to tell me.
I mean, yeah, I want to be. I don't want to be burned.
They do.
So, because we've got.
And she said, "Oh, yeah, your grandparents are lots.
You guys have some, yeah."
And she
where
said,
is your family at?
Your grandmother bought five lots in 1943.
Over by
only three people are buried in them. The last one was buried in 1955. So if you want to get buried here, there's two lots available as long as your relatives goes, because we can't sell them. But they can't, is what you're saying, George.
You can't.
You can't.
If there's names on the monument or it doesn't say things like that, because they can't.
Oh, okay.
She has her lot
and
her name, and she has specified those are her five.
Got
it. And you can't have four people.
No.
Everybody moved.
Okay. All right. I'm going to continue on here with Dan Kitty. Born in
1843,
Brooklyn, New York. He came to West Pere with his parents in 1850, was a helpful farmhand, and then went on to thriving lumbering and manufacturing. 1865, he married Matilda, his wife, then he continued on his career working for the Sorensen Shipyard. Dan was an avid hunter, and he was big into carving wooden duck decoys, and then decided, hey, I should probably build myself a boat. Mm-hmm. So he did. I believe it was just happenstance. He was out hunting, out in his boat, and someone, I believe from Chicago, said, hey, I really like your boat. How much are you selling it for? And I guess he wasn't really prepared for this, but he just named his price and sold it, and word spread, and he was the guy to then start building boats for everyone. Dan Kidney and Son's Boat Factory started up in his backyard, basically out of a glorified shed, I believe, which we kind of know in the area is off of a St. Orbert campus, the homestead was. And I believe that first factory is the gymnasium on St. Norbert campus. I didn't go to St. Norbert, so I didn't don't know specifically, but is that the second?
Yeah, just north of Van Dyke Gym.
Oh, the Van Dyke Gym. Okay. Let's see here. So I have some images.
Nice.
And obviously he was just very world renowned with the boats that he created. Everyone wanted one. These are beautiful, beautiful boats. I have some pictures from inside the factory here. Just a couple of these.
I've seen them. I got them home.
Less. Those are big.
So a lot of hunting boats, but also some cruisers with a nice canvas top on top, and I just mentioned earlier too that I had a gentleman from Minnesota contact me yesterday saying, hey, I just purchased this Dan Kidney boat. Do you know anything about that? I'm like, that's funny that you mentioned. mention that. So he has an original, and let's see here. Let me go to the. Here's another picture of. There's another one right outside the factory. Kyle, do you want to pass around that?
That is nice.
Mm-hmm. All right. Some images of the home. I don't know if that's gonna flip for me, but.
Is that here in the pier?
So this is not there anymore. This is currently a St. Norbert campus.
Oh, okay. Cross the river.
By the gym.
Cross the river.
By the gym.
Yeah.
They waited until Dan passed away before they knocked it down, though.
Oh, 25.
And I actually do have an image of him whittling here as well.
Hmm.
Imagine going from a duck decoy to a bolt.
Yes.
No kidding.
There you go.
What do they have in common?
All about the dynamics.
Nice. I hear crickets. Nice boats, huh?
They are nice boats.
Oh, look at that.
And that's part of the fact, one of the factories.
Oh, you can have it for, pass it on to her. Thank you. Mm-hmm. They're luxurious.
So
they're streamlined looking. You want it back there?
You want it? So you can see?
Thank you.
I need to get through two, and I hope we're ready at 10:02, so...